We drove around the old neighborhood for hours. BMX ravines, the flooded tennis courts frozen each year, Sean Thompson's broken lunchbox on my head. The air smells so familiar still. It floods my mind with innocence and firsts. My first crush, my first schoolyard fight, the first candy bar I stole from Circle K, and the first time I broke into my school after hours just to see if we could. I stole some books and some pens and a Paul Coffey rookie card. I'm finally able to tell my dad all the trouble I got in back then. I wonder if it was news to him, or if he did some of the same crap I did as a kid. I see myself in him. I always hoped that I would. So I told him about my first bush party with beer, and Ryan's angry mother running all over town looking for us. She even went to the movies where we said we were. All she found was kids necking, eating popcorn, and watching Back to the Future. Michael J. Fox was such a cool guy, it drove me fucking crazy. I used to jump off the highest peak and roll it out in the sand, the dust and dirt in our bloodstained knees. When's the last time I got a scrape? Fences used to be meant for hopping, not for keeping things inside. And pavement was meant for dangerous BMX ramps and playing tons of fucking street hockey. To my friends back then, I miss you all. I hope you're happy and fine. I like to think you hold those times as close to heart. I miss myself back then. If I could have just one piece of my life to live a million times over, it would be as close to heaven as I'll ever get. Because once I left, I learned that nothing lasts forever. Even the motto we shared and falsely believed and called and returned time and again. Always and forever.